Welcome, flip clock fans, and no, this is not a flip clock. This is the Seiko Sonola Transistor Time Data Wall Clock. While not a flip clock, it seems to me part of this design harkens back to the design of the earliest digital clock, which in turn is related to the inventor of the first flip clock. I'll explain more in just a second. I came upon this clock pictured here in the home of a wonderful 92-year-old British lady named Margaret, and just had to learn more about this clock and its workings. So I went to a Japanese auction site and bought this clock. While I have yet to receive it, I wanted to start a discussion about this type of clock. Unless you're familiar with various types of pendulum clocks, you may not have seen a clock of this type. I never had until I visited Margaret. While the early pendulum clocks are wound, with the mainspring providing the energy to keep the pendulum moving, which makes the clock work, the pendulums in these clocks are electromagnetic. Once started, they should keep moving until you remove the battery or the battery dies. These Seiko Sonola clocks are based on a brand of clock called the ATO clock, or ATO clocks. I don't know if you say it ATO or just say the word ATO. ATO clocks were marketed as far back as the 1920s. In the 1950s and 60s, a transistor was added to the electronics of these second-generation ATOs, making them more reliable. The pendulums of these clocks have two curved extensions that contain permanent magnets at the ends within their hollow cores. These alternately swing in and out of the two fixed coils. The transistor in this clock controls the current to what's called the motor coil on the right. The motor coil acquires a magnetic field when power flows through it, drawing the pendulum towards itself, which is the impulse which keeps the pendulum moving. The other coil acts as a trigger for the transistor to send current to the motor coil. As the magnetic rod passes into the trigger coil on the left, it generates a small current that is sent to the transistor. While the rod remains moving within the trigger coil, the power will remain on to the motor coil by the action of the transistor acting like a switch. Once the rod exits the trigger coil, the power to the transistor stops, which interrupts the power to the motor coil, causing the magnetic draw to cease, allowing the pendulum to continue its swing back into the trigger coil, repeating the process. The date and day feature of these time data models have wheels that remind me of the world's first digital clock designed by Austrian inventor Josef Paul Weber in 1883. Paul Weber, you may know, patented the world's first flip clock in 1890. Which is why this clock showed up on a YouTube channel devoted to flip clocks. Well, I hope you found this to be as curious as I did. Thanks for taking the time.